Good morning, friends. How y'all doing this morning? Praise the Lord. It's all about Jesus, not about Curly. But this is, I say Early but Curly, but it's not about Curly. It's all about Jesus. Okay, my friends. Excuse me. We're going to be in 1 Samuel this morning. 1 Samuel 7. Y'all please turn there with me. So we got to put away strange gods. Little g gods. We got to put away strange gods. As Allah and Muhammad and Buddha, those are false gods. We need to serve our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. He is our true God. Okay. Yes, serious man, we gotta get that. Well, God's powerful. Y'all, please turn that with me. 1 Samuel, over First Poles, First Station. Oh, don't catch your little girl. How about Jesus? Oh, but Jesus, not me. All right. There's 7:3. Here we are. You ready? And Samuel spake unto all the house of Israel, saying, If you do return unto the Lord with all your hearts, then put away the strange gods, and Ashtaroth from among you, and prepare your hearts unto the Lord, and serve him only. And he will deliver you out of the hand of the Philistines. All right, God, we got to serve him only. Him only. It says right there. It says, pray your hearts unto the Lord and serve him only. And he will just deliver you out of the hands of the Philistines. We need to serve our Lord only. He will deliver us, guys. Yeah, please pray with me. Dear Lord Jesus, help us all this morning. Help us all focus on you and your word every single day of our life, Lord. Help us not get distracted by this ungodly, simple, temporary world, Lord. Please, Jesus, help everybody, Lord. Help my boys right now, my young men. Help them. And one's in college, one's in school again. Please, I reckon this Monday morning they're back in school. Please, Jesus, I sure miss my boys, my young men. Help us focus on you and your word, Lord, not get distracted by this ungodly, simple, temporary world, Lord, because you are the answer. Help us, Jesus. Help us. As many kids yesterday in school and in church, they were getting saved. Lord, touching the hearts of the young generation, please help. Touch my boys' hearts. Touch all the boys, all the girls, all around the whole entire world, Lord. Help them all get saved before it's too late, Lord, because we're in the last days, I believe, Lord Jesus. Everybody believes. Help us, Jesus. Help us all. Focus on you and your word. Help us get away from them strange gods out there, the little g gods that people are trying to put before you, Lord. Help us put you first every day. Thank you so much for your mercy and for your grace. Your mercy from saving us from things that we do deserve, Lord. And your grace, Lord, for blessing us with things that we do not deserve. What a blessing. We got another day to praise you. Woohoo, come on, Jesus. Thank you so much. Heaven this morning as I preach. In your name we pray. Amen. All right, my friends. Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. Wow. 4 or 5, baby. God bless y'all. Thank y'all so much. It's early in the morning. I got to work tonight, so I ain't going to be so early with Curly tomorrow because I'm going to be sleeping at this time, I imagine. I'm going to have to try to give me a good old power nap before I go to work tonight, but I might try to DoorDash and work this morning a little bit if I can. But God is powerful. We got to put away strange gods, my friends. Stop idolizing stuff, okay? We need to stop idolizing stuff. I'm going to mark all these, but we're going to go to the Bible a little bit here, the first point, okay? Leviticus 19:4. Stop idolizing stuff, okay? Because stuff, I love the sound of the rustling of the pages, means we're trying to learn. Turn ye, 19:4, Leviticus. Turn ye not unto idols, nor make to yourselves molten gods. I am the Lord. Your God. He is the Lord, our God. We need to serve him and seek him. Not be trying to make up new idols for us. People trying to follow football. People trying to follow Hollywood. No, we need to follow the Lord. He is first. I'm going to 2 Kings. And that's the book after Samuel. 2 Kings 17:2. After 2 Samuel. 2 Kings 17:2. The Bible says right here. It says, 12. I'm glad I didn't start reading that. 12. Here we go. For they served idols, whereof the Lord had said unto them, ye shall not do this thing. He don't want us to serve idols. He wants us to serve him. He is a jealous God, and he will chastise your life if you get away from him, as I'm living proof of that. For they served idols, whereof the Lord had said unto them, ye shall not do this thing. We need to serve Jesus and not idols. Then we go to Ecclesiastes 8:11, because it is getting worse, my folks. It's getting worse out there. Ecclesiastes 8:11. That's going to be right before Isaiah, I believe. After Proverbs. Where was it? Yes, it is. Right after Proverbs, right before Ecclesiastes 8:11. Learn your Bible. Learn how to get to it. Learn where the pages are. I used to not know none of it. I mean, I'm dumb as a bag of rocks, my friends, okay? Y'all please understand, the Lord is powerful. He will change your life, I promise you. He will change your life. 8:11, because right here what the Bible says, because sentence against any evil work is not executed speedily. Therefore, the heart of the sons of men is fully set in them to do evil. The heart, when we're born, our hearts are set. Because sentence against an evil work is not executed speedily, therefore the heart of the sons of men is fully set in them to do evil. We're not to do evil, but the world is here to kill, steal, and destroy, trying to make sin okay. It's okay for a man to marry a man. It's okay for a woman to marry a woman. If you don't want that baby, just go ahead and kill it. Abortion is fine. No, it's not. No, it's not. We're going against God's laws. We have an instruction book. The Bible, B-I-B-L-E. Yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E. Bible, okay? Basic instructions before leaving Earth. Basic instructions before leaving Earth. We need to follow the Bible. Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me, as he says in John 14:6, as I almost say every day. It's not me, it's him. I'm quoting Scripture. Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh to the Father but by me, as he says. Not me. Him. Jesus Christ. God Almighty. God, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Blessed Trinity, the Godhead. They are all one. Okay, well, Samuel judged Israel. We'll go back to, I meant to hold my place there. I'm Samuel. It won't take long to get there once you know your Bible. My friend, 1 Samuel 7. 1 Samuel 7. We need to read it, we need to learn it, we need to love it, we need to live it, we need to share it. The Bible, what's going to last forever? The grass withereth, the flower fadeth, but the word of our God shall stand forever. Heavens and earth shall pass away, but his words shall not pass away. The Holy Spirit just popped there. That was Isaiah 48 and Matthew 24:35. So we need to read the word, my friend. Samuel 7:15. Y'all pause 1 second, we'll search that. Up early today. I'm going to try to do a little door dashing, I guess, and spread the word of Jesus with my testimonies. I encourage you, my friends, if you're saved by his grace through faith, please write up your own testimony, how you was before, how you are now, how he has done changed your life. And share with the world. Go ye into our world and preach the gospel to every creature, says in Mark 16:15. Let the joy of the Lord be your strength, says in Nehemiah 8:10. Because greater is he that is in me, I hope he's in you too. Greater is he that is in me, he is in this world. It's all about Jesus. 1 John 4:4. Now we're here in 1 Samuel 15. Right here, 1 Samuel 7:15. We're here where it says, and Samuel judged Israel all the days of his life. Samuel judged Israel all the days of his life. We are here for the Lord, my friends. Let's go to 1 Corinthians 15:1-4. I got this written down too. We're here for the Lord. 1 Corinthians 15. I jotted that down last night to go with this. Because God, you got to put away them strange gods. We're here for the Lord, my friends. We're here for the Lord. I ain't got work this morning, so I'm just trying to Share the word of God. This is the word, the word of God, which is quick and powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even unto the dividing asunder of the soul and the spirit, the joints and the marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. Praise the Lord. That's Hebrews 4:12. That just popped out of nowhere too. Because the grass, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. That's John 1:1 right there. Please write out the scripture now and look it up later. 15. 1 Corinthians 15, 1-4. Here we go. Moreover, brethren, I declare unto you the gospel. This is the gospel, which I have preached unto you, which also ye have received, and wherein ye stand, by which also ye are saved, if you keep in memory what I preached unto you, unless ye have believed in vain. We need not believe in vain. We need to know the truth, trust the Lord with all our heart, lean not unto thine own understanding, and all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Be not wise in thy own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. That's Proverbs 3:5-7, just popped on my mind there. But here we go, by number 2, 15:2, by which also ye are saved, and if ye keep in memory what I preached unto you, unless ye have believed in vain. We need not believe in vain. We need to know the truth, and let the truth make us free. His name is Jesus. John 8:32 right there. Number 3, for I delivered unto you first of all that which I also received, how that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, and that he was buried, and he rose again the third day according to the scriptures. This is the word of God. We need to follow it daily. We need to read it, learn it, love it, live it, and share it. He is so awesome. We need to pray for them that serve strange gods and despise us that are living for the true God, the one and only God. His name is Jesus, God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the blessed Trinity, the Godhead. He said on that cross, it is finished, and he bowed his head and gave up his ghost in John 19:30. That ghost, that Holy Spirit we have, once we invite him into our hearts to save us from our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness, that Holy Spirit is with us, which will never leave us nor forsake us. That's 1 John 1:9. And Hebrews 13:5, okay, write all the scripture down. Please look it back up. I'm not lying. This is all God's word. This is all the truth. We must know the truth and let the truth make us free, as I said in John 8:32, just a minute ago. But we need to pray for them that serve strange gods and despise us. But we need to love them. Love your enemies. Bless them that curse you. Do good to them that hate you. And pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you. Says it back in Matthew 5:44. Hello, Mr. Joshua, Mr. Evangelist. God bless all y'all. I can't name all y'all, but pray. Thank y'all so much. Early Curly. I'll pause one more second. We're going to listen to Paul. You see how Paul used to be Saul, and the Lord changed his life and turned him into Paul. Listen to Paul, how talking about himself here in 1 Timothy. Which is the other sound of the rest of the pages. Sounds cool. But yeah, 1 Timothy 1:12-17, we're going to read about Paul, how he's talking about himself right here, and how God done changed his life, and he can change your life too. We got to give it to God. Woo, turn it over. Lay it in his hands. Oh yeah, that was a song. I got another one playing, but we'll sing both of them, I guess. But number 12, and I thank Christ Jesus, our Lord, who hath enabled me, for that he counted me faithful, putting me into the ministry, who was before a blasphemer, who was before a blasphemer, a persecutor, and injurious, but I obtained mercy because I did it ignorantly in unbelief. He did it ignorantly in unbelief. And the grace of the Lord was exceeding abundant with the faith and love which is in Christ Jesus. This is a faithful saying that worthy of all acceptation, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am chief. As Paul saying, he was chief. But we need to be strong and of good courage to get saved by his grace through faith, which is not of ourselves, which is a gift from God, not of works, lest any man should boast. It says in Ephesians 2:8-9. We need to be strong and of good courage. Be not afraid. Neither be thou dismayed, for the Lord thy God is with thee, whithersoever thou goest. It says back in Joshua 1:9. Please write all this down. The other one was 1 John 1:9. Praise the Lord. Number 16 right here. Well, I'll read this number 15 one more time. This is the faithful saying, and that worthy of all acceptation, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am chief, as Paul was saying. Howbeit, for this cause I obtained mercy, that in me first Jesus Christ might show forth all longsuffering for a pattern to them which should hereafter believe on him to life everlasting. Now unto the King eternal, immortal, invisible, the only wise God, that be honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. Did y'all hear that right there? Now unto King eternal, immortal, invisible, the only wise God, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the Blessed Trinity, the Godhead, they are all one. Okay, my friends, so we need to pray for them. We need to pray for them. Because blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Y'all please pray with me now. I'm finished here. Dear Lord, thank you so much for everything you do, Lord. You're so amazing and powerful, Lord. Help us to dig into your word every single day of our life, Lord. Help us to dig in and try not to sin, Lord, because we were born sinners. Lord, help us all get saved by your grace through faith, which is not of ourselves, which is a gift from God, not of works, lest any man should boast, as you say in Ephesians 2:8-9, as I mentioned just a little while ago, Lord. Thank you so much. You got a plan for everything, Lord Jesus. Please help my boys, help my young men, help everything they're doing, Lord. Keep the hedge of protection around them. Help us all in the whole entire world. We seek you and live for you, Lord. Seek the Lord in your strength. Seek your face continually. Help us all seek the Lord in your strength. Seek your face continually, as you say in 1 Chronicles 16:11. Help us all, Jesus. Guide us all. Direct us all. Keep us safe, Lord. Please, Jesus. Guide us all. Keep the hedge of protection around us all, Lord. Please help us. Help me hear that singing here in just a second. Thank you so much for everything you do. In your precious holy name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. All right, my friends. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Woo, blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Your glorious name. You give and take away. You give and take away. My heart will choose to say, blessed be your name. Woo, y'all sing with me one more time. I'm going to take another sip of coffee. Pause one more second. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Woo, blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name. You give and take away. You give and take away. My mom passed. I miss my mom. My heart is choose to say, blessed be your name. She's been passed since 2014. Y'all please pray for my dad because he don't believe. Please pray for my dad. He loves his children. He loves to print me out testimonies for me. I keep on sharing the word. God, he loves his children. Please pray for my dad. Because he claims to be an atheist. So please pray for my dad. Please pray for us all. Let's all seek the Lord in his strength. Seek his face continually. Thank y'all so much for tuning in this morning. I'm going to try to get out there and DoorDash and share the word of Christ. But first, I got to go make a short there on the lake. Well, God bless y'all. Y'all have a good day. It's early with Gurley. Bye-bye.